And when I say this, it literally made me sick to my stomach to the thought that I was a female. Today I am doing a video without Justice, of course, because I've seen she did a video what it's like to dating a trans man. So basically, I'm basically doing a reaction video towards her and letting you guys know what it's really like dating a trans man, or how it is, or tips on dating a trans man, basically.
Y'all excuse fate right there. Fate. Hey. Yeah, that's a little
chill spot. Anyways, but today you guys actually can see me without my durag on. I usually have waves going on. Whatever the case, maybe I always have waves. But I'm trying something new with the curly hair. So just give it a little update on that. And I'm trying to give the durag a rest because you see, y'all see these lines, bro. Anyway, this is besides the point. What we'll be getting into today is about the, if you want me to be honest with you, I live my life as any other normal man would live his life. Wake up, I'm a man. Go to sleep, I'm a man. Middle of the day, I realize, hey, I'm a man. I came a long way with this transition. I've been on TV 2 years, so I came a long way from where I started, and by that I'm saying, like, when it comes to family, they weren't really, well, besides my siblings, they were accepting. My siblings accepted me, my sisters, my brothers, they all accepted me, so that's perfectly fine. But when it came to my mother, my stepfather, and my grandmother, that's a whole nother story. When I say that, I mean, like, my grandmother, she's very religious. She's a Christian. So that was, like, kind of hard to run by her. So I tried to opt my way out of saying anything to her, but eventually it did get out. Pretty sure my mother told her, or I told her, one of the two. But being that it was told to her, she didn't really like that I was doing it, and she kept asking me what happened to you as a child or anything like that. Don't get me wrong, I love my grandmother. She's the best thing ever. But she just couldn't wrap my mind around why I wanted to be a man. She said, you know, there's so much things you can do as a woman. Why do you want to change that? Well, grandmother and mother, being a woman, it wasn't just for me. I just could not live my life being a female another day. It literally, and when I say this, it literally made me sick to my stomach to the thought that I was a female. Like, for 19 years, I was a whole female. I can't say I enjoyed, growing up was okay. Didn't really get into that transitioning until I got a little bit older. Y'all have to ignore Fade, by the way. She's just living her best life. Bing. That's all she does all day is sleep, and she's only one. So, anyways, but
I think we're making eye contact
with the camera. Anyways, I couldn't do it no more. It was stressful. Cause it almost came to the point where I just couldn't even look at myself in the mirror any longer. I always idolized being a guy. Since I was a kid, I was a tomboy, first of all. Play rough, play with all the boys, was cool with all the boys in the neighborhood. Everyone saw me as a brother. Not a little girl, a little sister. I never played softball. I actually played baseball, karate, boys. Everything that I did was included God, little boys. That's all I did. It's all I ever wanted to be around. So growing up, I became a stud, quote unquote. So although I was a stud, I still wanted to be a guy, but I just couldn't get into the trans, being a transgender, because I read so much hate on it. I didn't want to go through that. I read on, you know, you're going to go to hell if you transition, you know. But as I got older, I reached 19 and I was like, I don't believe in that kind of stuff. I'm Muslim. I don't believe in that. I converted to Muslim, by the way. When I say that, I converted to Muslim. But I don't believe in that. So I was like, all right. Which is what they're saying about being a trans is not true at all. So why should I even believe that? So therefore, I just went my own route and decided to transition. So that's basically a little sum it up about how I got into transitioning. My mother and my grandmother, they're accepting it, but they don't want to, but they have no other choice because they say they love me. They have not treated me any different. I still get treated the same. The only thing that does bother me about our relationship when it comes to my transition is that they still call me she. That's really, it bothers me. It gets under my skin. But when we're in public, my mother will say he. I still let her call me by my first name because I don't see that changing anytime soon, because I know that's what she is used to. She does not want to call me Jean Villier, so I don't let her. So I just say, okay, you can call me by my first name. And when my grandmother, she calls me she too, it bothers me. My grandmother doesn't, no, she's just, she don't say it often, but you know, whenever it slips. So she's more better than she's better than my mother. My mother, she says she cannot see herself calling me a he. And I'm just like, but anybody else can see me as a he, mom. You saying she, no one sees a she. So that's just something that I've come to terms with. I let it slide because she's my mother and my grandmother, and I love them to death, but sometimes it does kill me and irritates my soul when they say it. But as far as I can see, I can't do nothing about them doing it. I didn't talk to them plenty of times. My grandmother, she's just not going for it. That's just plain and simple, and I understand. Okay, cool. Mother, she can come around just a little bit and try to, you know, make me feel better about it. But then again, it's like I'm hurting them in the same token because I made this decision. So I guess I gotta, it's a win-win situation. I don't know. My real father, he accepts it. That's all I can say about that. He doesn't treat me different. The other day, he even asked me, hey, so what do you want me to call you? I said, Dad, you can call me by my first name. That's perfectly fine. Just don't get your pronouns messed up. Please don't. I already have to deal enough with that with my mother, my grandmother, and my stepfather. So please don't. Don't let me down with this one. So he's actually doing good. He actually called, you know, he's talking to my aunt. Okay, that's not the story, I'll get into that later. Anyways, but tips on dating trans man. So that's basically the story about how everything is with when it comes to my family, and now everything's not perfect on that side. So I'm still struggling a little bit with them, so that's something I had to work on with them. When it comes to the tips on dating trans man, all I can say is that I'm a little high-headed. I'm a little high-headed, and especially when I don't take my shots. I have a bad temper. Attitude is ridiculous. It's crazy how angry I can get, or mad I can get so quick and irritated. I hate it. And the shots only made it worse. So when I don't, so I try not to take my shot. Like usually I can go a week or two without taking my shot, and it just gets worse. Don't recommend that. And if you are dating a trans man, or if you are a trans man, please take your shot. It's not, the attitudes are just awful. It's just drowsy and So when I say tips on being a trans man, oh, I'm sorry, dating a trans man, I really don't have no tips, actually. It's just how you go about it. You would treat a trans man just like any other man, if you're into that, or any other relationship, you know? You don't pick and choose on how you wanna treat us. We're not some play toy. We're not something that you play with. We're not an experiment. I've actually been talked to like I am an experiment. I had a couple girls that wanted to experiment with me because I was a trans man. I just didn't see the fun in that. So why would you? That's just something that they was into. They said, oh, I wanted to see what it's like to be with a trans man. Oh, because you have a penis now. Okay. I don't think that shit. That's just beyond me. So I have no work. Fate? That's just beyond me. So, I'm not some experiment that you can play with. Don't treat us as such. Don't talk to me just because I'm a trans man. You wanna know what I'm all about or what it's like to be with a trans man. I'm the same. It's the same way with any other guy, any other female. Besides, one body part is just different than the other. That's it. Like I said, I'm not. And I'm not really doing much of justice reactions on her. What she said to me about what she said about on hers. I can say that she. What I can say is, oh, she wanted to know. Why did I put myself on as a female on the dating website? Well, I didn't think females would be attracted to a trans man. Straight females would be attracted to a trans man. So, because most probably would have been like, hey, you were just a female, now you're a man, so I don't know about all that. And they might have been a little iffy about it. I didn't want to go through that. Didn't have time for it, so I knew if I would put myself as a woman on the site, they might go for it. And by the way, I was on that website. I had hair. Okay, I signed up for that thing a year ago. I had hair. I just cut my hair in July. I mean June. Well, it's about to be a year, but I had hair. And so, you know, you looked at me, you didn't see a trans man. So I said, whatever. It's not that I was preying on any females or gay females, because whatever the case may be, it wasn't that. It was just me not coming to terms of who I am or what I am, so I just decided to go with it and mark myself as a female. Clearly I wasn't that, so that's the only reason why. And I do want to give a huge shout out to Justice's parents. Her mother and her father, simply because they have been way more accepting than my parents. Their pronouns are exactly the way it should be. They're amazing, and they are just like what a family should have. And I do feel sorry for, so yeah, I love them, they're great. But I do feel sorry for people that's not accepted by the trans, that they're coming out as trans and their family doesn't accept it and they're young. Or, you know, all their parents have, you know, they only depend on their parents, you know what I mean? So I really do feel sorry about that. And I really do hope that situation gets better. Because I feel as if if that's what your kid is, that's just what your kid is. If they don't feel right in being a female, then why would you allow them to go through that? You know, they say they want to transition, and that's just it. Let them transition. Let them be happy. People fail to realize once you do this, is that's literally their happiness. Like, you could take so much away. Like, it's just something that all I can say is that it's something that made me happy. It made me feel alive again. I came alive again after 19 years of almost feeling dead. I had a little left in me, and I felt like that was about to go away too if I didn't make a quick decision. I was on the verge of getting kicked out. My mom wasn't with it either, but I sat down and talked to my mom and told her this is something that I have to do. I even snuck to go to Charleston for my appointment to get on my shots. I chose my happiness over my mother's happiness. You should want to see your child happy no matter what, regardless. Fate. Y'all, that's really her resting spot. She would leave the room while we're sleeping and go sleep on the couch. That's just ridiculous. Whatever. But thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate y'all. And like, comment, and subscribe. And we have more videos. All right.